all gave some. Some gave all. Some stood through for the red, white, and blue, and some had to fall. And if you ever think of me, think of all your liberties and recall.
In laying of the wreath, in the words of our brother and national secretary, it could not be explained in a better way. The wreath laying ceremony in his words. Normal voices turned to hushed whispers, drowned out by the deafening silence of the magnitude of this sacred site. A sea of black vests and red and gold patches in stark contrast to the sea of white markers and manicured green grass. They arrive in small groups, making their way up the hill, each one in contemplative thought. Children walking beside them with unknowing expectations. They sit in quiet reverence, eyes and heads moving back and forth in silence, as if moved by some unseen force. Following each step, each movement of those whose sole purpose is to guard one unknown soldier. Like the sound of a clock, each click of the heel, each precise and beautiful movement building to a moment of historic proportions. Chests swell and faces beam with pride as four brothers stand ready at the top of the pathway. Four brothers who intimately know and have felt the sacrifice of those who now permanently inhabit these grounds. A voice breaks the silence not by anyone in the crowd, but by those who are tasked by commitment to honor and duty. Then once again, silence, as four brothers step forward onto hallowed ground to place a representation of something we hold with the utmost respect, to represent our honor and respect to those who have sacrificed so much for us. And as we stand in prideful reverence, the bugler sounds his horn, only matched by the sounds of tears striking the ground. And in those moments, we are one. We are fire and iron.
Some gave all.